It feels like an absolute age since I last reviewed Amplenote, and today I wanted to give you a refreshed outline of whether Amplenote's right for you. Now, this application is well known for being an interesting one for combining the three productivity areas, tasks, calendar, and notes. And in today's view, we're going to help you to find out whether it is a right note-taking app slash task management slash calendar app for you. We're going to go over the free plan and give you an idea of whether it's suitable for you. And we're going to do another video about the premium pricing to give you an outline on that. So before we begin, welcome to Tool Finder. My name is Francesco D'Alessio and I'll be helping you to do the review today. But if you're hunting for any productivity applications, you can jump over there and find some more. Now, I want to start out with some of the main features. Now, the main features are, of course, the note-taking abilities, but there are also tasks and calendar in this. So we'll touch on that and then we'll dive into the pros and cons. So first things first, let's start with the pricing. And as you can see, this is the free plan that I'll be using today. And you can also see there's a pro and unlimited and founder plan. The pro plan is priced just shy of $6 per month and the unlimited plan at $10 a month. There's also a founder plan, which is essentially a sort of early adopter pricing, which is much more designed for those who are obsessed with this and also get the power that you do and don't just get as a regular user, like, for example, a Discord channel and one-to-one calls as well. Now, obviously, this pricing is fairly reasonable. At $6 per user per month, that's quite good. And you do get some of the more details abilities like the desktop application, the graph view, and the sidebar notes, as well as syncing external calendars, which really do enhance what you've already got. Now, inside of the free plan, you do get the desktop type experience, but you also get it on Windows and Mac via I think it's called a progressive web app, which is basically like sort of a Chrome extension, but on its own, if that makes sense. I'll show you what that means in a moment. So that's more about the pricing. So as you can see, this is the progressive web app. You can see it's sort of like just a Chrome extension sort of living on its own. And you can see here that I can start taking notes in the daily jots area. Now, the daily jots area is essentially an area that you can use to bring together all of your notes. It's sort of like daily notes and allows you to create and see the full note. Inside of a full note, you can use all of the regular text formatting options that you'd see inside of most note-taking applications. And you can also sync this as well. And in the top right-hand corner, you can publish the note. You can apply a vault encryption to it, which is very much focused on security. And you can also manage the tasks, download the note, and do all the regular stuff that you'd expect inside of a note-taking application. And the stuff down here is all of the completed tasks, the hidden tasks, and the backlinks that you've created. So for example, in this case, if I added a reference to another note, then if I go into that note, down at the bottom, I should be able to see that there the backlink is. You can see that it's referenced there, and that's quite helpful to see. So I can bring in any of those references like you would inside of the other backlink or bi-directional link applications. Now, you can add a table in here. It's very basic. It doesn't really do an incredible amount. You can also add in multimedia and things like quotes and attaching links and things like that. So in terms of other abilities, multimedia images are a little bit more customizable. You do get centered and you get distract image. So you can start to see that notes are pretty powerful. You can also manage tasks as part of those notes. So for example, if I want to create a task, I can do that with my my keyboard, and I could type in task one. And as you can see there, if I type in the exclamation mark, it brings up some of the options. So you can add a start time of tomorrow at 9 a.m, for example, and enter it, and then you can start to see the details. Now, if you want to open it up, you can bring together the duration, set a reminder. And the reason why it's helpful is because it's got a progressive web app, which means that it's going to come through as notifications through there. So if I press done, now that's pretty cool. And I can go to the tasks area and I should be able to see it. So for example, do this week, I can see that item appears here. So there is a feature inside of this experience called task score. So for example, if I wanted to, I could open this up, and this is an algorithm it attributes to the importance of the task. So if I go up here, this task score got an 8.4. And that's probably because it's much more important and it's attributed it as something much more valuable. So for example, if I were to change this to urgent, as you can see, the algorithm changes and it gives me a 7.6. If I needed to do it by today, then you can see it comes up as a task score of 15.6 and as a red indicator. So if you struggle with prioritization, then something like this can be incredibly effective to narrow options down for you. So you can also filter down as well per note, which is quite helpful. And as those notes earlier, those tasks, you can see they're completed, come up as part of it. And you can see a sort of like a, not the algorithm come up, but the importance of the task will boost up. So if you wanted managing your tasks for today, you can see, start to see those attributes come up as well. Now you can also manage the tasks as part of that and see maximum target and maximum open tasks as well. And that's really a great sort of shortcut that you can create here. You can sort of automate that process and build your own grouping system. Now the calendar is a handy feature too, because you can see any tasks that were completed at a certain time. So here you can see that this one was meant to be for Monday at today at 9 a.m. and you can see it was completed, and that gives you an indication of that task being completed. You've also got a week view, which is quite nice. And the nice thing about this is you can drag items in, which is a helpful time blocking ability. And this goes a step further as well by using a personal filter as well. So you can have your work calendar and your personal calendar. Now, obviously the benefit to going pro is to connect with Google Calendar and Outlook, which means you can have as many different views as you want. That's like a full week view, that's like a 4-day view, which I quite like, and the ability to skip forward as well, which is quite nice, as well as being able to organize your tasks. I quite like this feature where you can see the importance. You can organize them based on task score, for example, or most recent. That is basically the default task duration, and you can basically drag them in as that, which is quite helpful. So for example, if this one takes 30 minutes, everything's gonna be 30 minutes. If I change it to 90, then you should see. So for example, if you're doing like large task planning, then you could drag those in and sort of organize that structurally. And the personal work lives separate to each other, which is quite nice. Now, obviously that's really the extent of the free plan in terms of what it offers in terms of core features. There are additional plugins and abilities that are built by the community to help you to manage your account, like voice notes, Excalibur Draw, and things like that. You can go through them at your own sort of pace, because there's quite a few of them. It's 88, which is pretty good. The graph mode I will do in a full review in terms of the advanced abilities. But in terms of pros and cons, what I quite like about this application is the fact that you can use it in the free capacity with some really good abilities in terms of connecting up your tasks and connecting up your calendar, and having that just core basic productivity system, which is quite nice. And you can see they encapsulate it as something called the idea execution funnel, which is really nice. And having them hosted in one location is really, really nice. Another huge bonus that they underrate, I think, inside of their marketing, not their fault, just I think they should push it, is the task score is an incredible tool that most other productivity apps don't actually have, which is something that they've sort of got a market lead on, which is quite nice, or at least maybe people don't find it as a feature, but it's an incredibly powerful feature for task management. And the calendar mode is really good. Even if you don't use this with Google Calendar and Outlook, you've already got a system for managing your tasks from day one, which is something that, in my opinion, this is actually better than what currently Evernote have in terms of their calendar setup. So this has been around for a while, so this is good. My cons are that the design is not so attractive. The fact that the desktop availability isn't from day one, in terms of you have to use this progressive web application, which is a bit of a pain. And also the fact that there are just some nuances to learning this, like up here, like it's just getting your head around with, okay, why is it three notes that are associated with the source notes? There's a filter button here. There's quite like small things that are like quite extensive to get into. So it does take a little bit of time to learn. But again, it's one of these powerful applications that I think do a pretty good job. Even the smaller abilities, like we mentioned, like the sort of progressive daily completion of tasks, which is quite nice. Also, all of the sort of the abilities in note mode work really well. So this is great if you're somebody coming from GTD, one, a host of productivity systems in one, and need something that's reliable and easy to go with. I've never had a problem using this in tests, and also I've never heard people having a problem with this. They find it to be a reliable application. I think the downside of it is that the design isn't as attractive as some of the other options in the market. But it's regularly updated, has a good reputation, and some very unique features that bring your productivity in one location. So thank you so much for stopping by in today's video. If you need more insights on Amplenote, you can jump over to toolfinder.co to explore more. And if you're maybe not made your mind up, you can find some reviews there too. So thank you very much, and I'll see you all in a future video, I'm sure. Cheerio.